Poland's new culture minister tries to ban Nobel winner's play, claiming public money must not be used to subsidize pornography. A scandal in Wrocław, the play Death and the Maiden by Austrian writer Elfried Jelinek recently premiered at the Polski Theater, only to be condemned by some as pornography. The work has been described as one which brings women to the stage as eternally repressed in the Western European cultural tradition. Members of a Catholic organization opposed it being shown, complaining that the play includes sexually explicit scenes.
Sex is niedozwolony publicznie.
12 people have been arrested after trying to block the entrance to the theater which was showing the play. The further drama unfolded involving the newly appointed culture minister Piotr Gliński. In a letter to the chairman of Lower Silesia, the culture minister called for the cancellation of the play. The city replied that it doesn't interfere with freedom of artistic expression in any way.
Rozumiem, że ktoś niepotrzebnie zupełnie wywołał histerię.
Nie jest prawdą, że jestem przeciwko scenom.
It is not true that I am against scenes of nudity in films or theatre, because for years it has been acceptable, if it has artistic justification. I very much regret that this, mostly political battu, is using such tricks. I was not protesting against nudity. I was protesting against spending public money on hard pornography.
Theater director Krzysztof Miszkowski claims there is no pornography in the play and invited Gliński to watch it so that he could judge for himself instead of returning state censorship.
The biggest reward was a standing ovation after the premiere. I dedicate it to Deputy Prime Minister Mr. Gliński and once again urge him to resign.
Glinsky's opponent said his attempt to stop the performance amounts to a violation of freedom of speech.
We have to deal with the collision of freedom of art, freedom of society, and the restrictions imposed upon us. Nobody felt confused, nobody left during the play, and nobody was offended.
The event has brought to light the rising influence of Poland's new conservative pro-Catholic government and growing intolerance. Within a week of being sworn in this month, the Law and Justice government has sacked Poland's intelligent chiefs and passed illegal amendments that could allow political control of the constitutional court. Маргарита Ситник, Ігор Антонюк, репортер from Warsaw.